From going undrafted in 2016 to becoming a champion in 2019, that's Fred Van Vliet for you. A lot can be said about the man and his mentality, but let's go back in time and see how he started. Hardships are a part of life, and Fred Van Vliet is no stranger to them. Having lost his father at the age of 5, Fred's been through a lot. Growing up in a rough neighborhood of Rockford, Illinois, he found solace in basketball. He started training with his stepfather and stepbrothers. Going up against two older brothers, Fred had no option but to get better. Throughout his high school career, Fred always believed it didn't matter where he played, as long as he was leading the team. After playing college basketball for 4 years with Wichita State, Fred decided to enroll for the 2016 NBA draft, attending 18 tryouts in 30 days. Making a roster was Fred's only goal. Fred was at a draft party with friends and family when he saw 60 names being called out while he remained undrafted. With a clear goal in his mind, he resolved to bet on himself. Fred managed to sign a contract that guaranteed him 3 summer league games with Raptors 905, an affiliate team of Toronto Raptors. Impressive showings in the summer league and training ensured that Fred managed to get that coveted 15th spot on the Raptors roster. July 18th, an important day to remember for us in the story of Fred Van Vliet. Fred decided to don the number 23. Not surprising for a guy who comes from Rockford, a town just 90 minutes away from Chicago. Fred was placed in a team which already had 3 players playing in his position, in Kyle Lowry, Corey Joseph, and Dellen Wright. But he still managed to get decent minutes, which was unusual for a rookie. 2017 saw him and fellow Raptor Pascal Siakam play an important part as the 905 Raptors won the D-League Championship. Few realized these two would help the Raptors winning the NBA title just 2 years after winning the D-League. Impressive performances in the D-League, coupled with the departure of Corey Joseph, saw a sharp rise in Fred's minutes per game in the 2018 season. By now, Fred had made a name for himself. Courtesy his gritty defense, strong moves in the post, fine shooting from behind the line, and excellent playmaking abilities. But his first appearance as a starter still eluded him as he kept coming off the bench. His efforts did get him a 6th Man of the Year nomination though. Fred decided to bet on himself once more by signing a shorter 2-year contract with the Raptors. The 2018-19 season saw the Raptors make a move that would change the legacy of the team, the city, and the entire sporting history of Canada. They made a trade that sent DeMar DeRozan to San Antonio Spurs and brought in Kawhi Leonard. This season saw Fred's minutes go up once again. November 17th, an important date in Fred's career. He became the first player from Rockford to start an NBA game. And what could have been a better place to start for an Illinois native than the United Center, the home of the Chicago Bulls? With Kyle Lowry, Kawhi Leonard, Danny Green, Pascal Siakam, Mark Gasol, and Fred Van Vliet, the Raptors were formidable and qualified as a first seed in the Eastern Conference. After making a few appearances as a starter in the regular season, the playoffs saw Fred lead from the bench again. While the Raptors were on a roll, the same couldn't be said about Fred. He started the playoffs well, but then, over the next 14 games, his averages dropped. He managed just 3.3 points and 2.8 assists per game on 20% shooting from the field and 14% from the three-point line. 20th May 2019, another important day to remember. Fred was blessed with a baby boy, and that seemed to turn his fortunes around. On June 13, 2019, history was created as the Toronto Raptors defeated the defending champions Golden State Warriors to win the first championship in the franchise's history. Kawhi Leonard's key performances won him a Finals MVP. And guess who finished second in the Finals MVP race? The 2019-20 season saw him become a regular starter. He also became the first Raptor to score 30 points and dish out 10 assists in a playoff game. He joined the elite club of Damian Lillard, Stephen Curry and Chris Paul as the only NBA players to record 30-plus points, 10-plus assists and 8-plus three-pointers in a playoff game. But alas, the journey to the NBA Finals was halted by the Celtics in an Eastern Conference semifinals that went till Game 7. Fred's contract was now up and it was time to make a decision. His efforts in bringing a championship to the city, his uncanny resemblance with Canadian superstar Drake, and his roller coaster life story made him a fan favorite in the city of Toronto. November 22nd, another key date. Fred's bet paid off. He created history by signing the largest contract by an undrafted player when he sealed a four-year extension to stay in Toronto. Fred has never been shy to express his love for Toronto as he considers himself an honorary Canadian. The 2021 season was a bit different for Fred and the Raptors as they had a new home in Tampa, away from Toronto due to COVID-19. 3rd February 2021, another memorable night in Fred's career. He broke the franchise record for most points, dropping 54 against the Orlando Magic. Fred's fine form continued as he hit a career high points per game in the 2021-22 season. With an able partner in Pascal Siakam, Fred led the Raptors back into the playoffs with 48 wins as the fifth seed in the Eastern Conference. He had a great stretch in early January, where over six games, Fred averaged 31.2 points, 6.7 assists, and 4.7 rebounds per game while shooting 47% from the field, 44% from beyond the arc, and 96% from the free throw line. Last season, Fred was back at it again. He finished with a career high 7.2 assists per game and stole the ball 1.8 times a game, which was also a career high. However, despite a valiant 26 points, 12 rebounds and 8 assists against the Chicago Bulls, Fred's Raptors lost a close playoffs battle. But Fred's story doesn't end here. This is only the beginning. In life, whenever things don't go your way, don't fret, just be like Fred.